Hello everyone, I am Amit Maru and today in this video we are going to discuss about merge sort algorithm. In merge sort algorithm we are using concept of divide and conquer strategy. First we have to divide our instance into different parts, then find out the solution of every part and then merge the solution of each and every part. It is simply known as divide and conquer concept. The same concept we'll use to sort the list of number into ascending order, and this algorithm is known as merge sort algorithm. So let us discuss a merge sort algorithm with one example. Suppose we have a list of a random number like 38 27 43 3 9 82 and 10. So as per the merge sort algorithm and as per the divide and conquer concept, the first step is we have to divide our list of number into different parts. So we have to divide as per the merge sort algorithm. We will divide this list of number into two parts. So here total number of elements are 7. So when we divide into two parts, at the time first part will have a 4 number of elements and second part will have 3 elements. So let us divide into two parts. So as per the merge sort algorithm, here we are dividing first part, that is 38, 27, 43 and 3, and second part will have a 9, 82 and 10. So the first step is we have to divide our list of number into two parts, first part and second part. Wherever it is even number of elements, at that time we will have a same number of element in left as well as right. Whenever odd number of elements, at that time we will have one element more in either first part or second part. So for example, 4 elements are there in left part and 3 elements are in a right part. So again we can divide left as well as right part because we have more than one elements. So here we can divide into two parts. So the first part will have 38 and 27 and second part will have 43 and 3. In right side also again we can divide into different parts, into two parts. So first part will have a 982 and second part will have 10. Now further this part will not be divided into different parts because only one element is available, but still here we can divide into two parts. So 38 will be in left part and 27 will be in right part. Likewise here also we can divide 43 in left part and 3 into right part, and 9 will be in left and 82 will be in right part. So in this way we can divide our elements. Now further division is not possible because all are the individual elements, so further division is not possible. Now the next step is once all the elements are separate, then we have to go reverse and we have to merge the different elements. So here we have divided until we get all the elements individual. Once we get all the elements individual, at that time we have to start to merge the element. But when we start to merge the element, at that time we have to retain that the element must be in ascending order. So for example, when we merge this both the elements 38 and 27, then 27 must be first, then after 38. So this part will be merged like 27 first, then after 38. When we merge these two elements, at that time 3 will be first and 43 will be second. When we merge these two part, at that time 9 will be first and 82 will be in second. And here only one element is available. So that we can get the pair of elements like 27, 38, 3, 43, 9, 82 and the last, that is 10 element. Now when we merge this both the list, this list has two element, this list has two element. When we start to merge this both the list, at that time we have to merge in ascending order only. But how it is possible? We have to compare first element of first pair like 27. We have to compare with the first element of second pair, that is 3. So 27 will be compared with 3, and which one is minimum, that will be stored in our final, or we can say third array. So 3 will be stored inside this array and index will be increased and will be compared with 43. It means that second time 27 will be compared with 43. Now the minimum value is 27, so second time 27 will be inserted in the list. and index of this list will be increased by 1. Then after 38 will be compared with 48, so 38 is minimum, so 38 will be inserted at the end, 43 will be inserted. In this way we will have a list of number like 3, 27, 38 and 43. So these all are the in ascending order. Likewise here 9 will be compared with 10 first, so 9 is minimum, so 9 will be inserted first. And then after index of this part, for example we are considering I index for this part, then I will be increased by 1. Then after second time 82 will be compared with 10, so 10 is minimum, so 10 will be inserted. And then after only last element, that is 82, will be inserted, so we can get 9, 10 and 82. Now when we merge this both the list of elements, at the time as we discussed, the first element of first part will be compared with the first element of second part. For example we are considering index for the first array, that is I, and index for the second array is for example j. Then we have to compare first element 3 with the 9, so the minimum value is 3, so 3 will be inserted first. Then after the index of I, index I will be increased by 1, so I will point 27. So 27 will compare with the 9, but the 9 is minimum, so 9 will be inserted in the array. And the index j will be increased by 1. So j will point now next time to the 10, and the 27 and 10 will be compared. So 10 is minimum, so 10 will be stored inside the array. And likewise 27 will be inserted, then after 38 will be inserted, 43 will be inserted, and then 82 will be inserted. In this way we can get list of number into ascending order. This concept is known as merge sort algorithm. So let us discuss pseudo code of merge sort algorithm. As per the pseudo code, we have to call merge sort function, and we are passing a as an argument, and the a has a size n, so 0 to n minus 1. Low indicates the first element, this is the index of first element, and the high indicates a last element. If the value of low is less than the high, it means that number of elements are there in the array, more than one elements are there in the array, then we have to divide into two parts. So mid is equal to low plus high divided by 2, so we can get middle element. So as we discussed, first we have to divide into two parts, first part as well as second part. So first part has an index low, means the first element, and the mid, that is the last element of the first part. And second part has a mid plus 1, that is the first element, and high is the last element. So this merge sort will be continuously called itself, it is a recursion, and until we get individual elements. When we get all the elements are individual, at that time we have to start to combine. So combine function will call, and will combine continuously all the parts until we combine all the elements of the array. So as we discuss, we have to, at the time of combining the elements, we have to compare first element of first part with the first element of second part, and minimum element will be inserted in our third array. So same logic we have to write here. So for example, k is one index, that is a low, I is an index, that is low, and j is equal to mid plus 1, that is the first element of second part. So now first we have to check if I less than or is equal to mid and j less than or is equal to high. At that time we have to compare a of I less than or is equal to a of j or not. A of I is the first element of first part, and a of j is the first element of second part. If first element of first part is less than or is equal to the first element of second part, then a of I will be inserted in our third array, that is temporary array, tm k is equal to a of I. So the minimum value will be inserted in third array, and index of same array will be increased. So the index is I, so I will be increased by 1, I plus plus, and k is equal to k plus 1. If this condition is false, it means that the first element of second part is smaller, then we have to insert the first element of second part in our temporary array, and the value of j will be increased by 1. Likewise, the k will be increased by 1, k is equal to k plus 1. This process will continue until the value of I is less than or equal to mid and J less than or equal to high. It means that until we add all the elements of first part and all the elements of second part. For example, the first element has only one or two elements, and second has for example more than five or six elements. That first part may be inserted in the third array. At the time we have to insert all the elements in same sequence of second part, and for that we have to write two different while loop, such as while I less than is equal to mid. It means that our first part is still pending and second part has already been inserted, so that we have to insert all the elements in same sequence of first part, like temp of k is equal to a of I, and I is equal to I plus 1 and k is equal to k plus 1. Now second while loop j less than or is equal to high, it indicates that the first part has already been inserted and second part is still pending. So the all the elements of second part will be inserted in same sequence, like temp of k is equal to a of j, and j is equal to j plus 1 and k is equal to k plus 1. So in this way second part will be inserted inside the third array, that is temporary array, and we can get list of number into ascending order. Now when we talk about the analysis of the algorithm, so as we discuss, every time we are dividing into different two parts. So the first part has a half element and second part has a half element. So first part required T of n by 2 time complexity, and second part required T of n by 2 time complexity, and then we are merging both the parts at the end of the algorithm. Once we get all the elements are separate, then we have to start to merge. So merging required C into n time complexity, or we can say the linear time complexity. So we can write 2 into T of n by 2 plus C n. So as per the master method, we can solve this recurrence equation. So as per the master method, the A is equal to 2, B is equal to 2, K is equal to 1 and P is equal to 0. So the time complexity of a Matsuda algorithm is theta of n raised to log base b into a, and log raised to p plus 1 into n. So put the value of a, b, p and k in this equation, then we can get theta of n log n. So the time complexity of Matsuda algorithm is n log n. Thank you.